Rashawn, you grew up in Auburn. You played at Alabama. You play professional football now in Nashville, Tennessee. There's nobody better to ask about Southeastern Conference football than you. When your teammates ask you, why is SEC football such a big deal? How do you explain it?
Man, I would say it's just the culture, man. You know, football players who love, truly love football, who were born and raised to play this game, man. You know, that's the type of football players you get out of the SEC, guys that are gritty, who play with violence, guys who are extremely athletic. I mean, you got guys who are running sub 4.4, 4.5s at 250 pounds, DNs, you know, linebackers, offensive linemen who are running 4.8s and stuff. So, I mean, these are really extremely athletic human beings, man, coming out of the SEC. So you could definitely see why people rave so much about the SEC.
Is there almost a culture among professional football players who played in the SEC like you guys come into the league as part of a fraternity almost?
Oh, no doubt. You know, anytime you hear a guy that's from the Southeastern Conference, you know, there's a different type of respect because, you know, those guys come from, you know, a conference where guys are playing some of the most elite talent in the NCAA. So, you know, you get that, the big man on campus type feel sometimes when you get into the NFL.
So when you go into a place like Baltimore for a divisional playoff game, and man, those fans are great in Baltimore. Give them total credit, but you've seen that before traveling around the SEC, haven't you?
Oh, no doubt, man. You know, I was playing in an atmosphere like that almost every Saturday, man. I remember Bryant Denny Stadium, just having all of those fans out there screaming at the top of their lungs, trying to get the quarterback and their audibles, you know, to be as difficult as possible, man. And that was probably one of the greatest atmospheres I've been a part of. So it was something that was, you know, definitely not new to me because it was something that I was planning every Saturday.
The SEC has dominated the draft in recent years in terms of putting players in the National Football League. What's the one attribute that sticks out to you the most that you felt like translated well from your SEC days to the NFL?
Man, I would just say my speed, man. I think that's the number one thing a lot of guys, you know, from the South is our speed, man. And, you know, speed kills. Anytime you can use that in your game and being able to get off the ball and be able to make plays like that, you're going to make a lot of those plays in the NFL.
Now, see, we're friends now. We've known each other a while. You know, I love you. I love what you do. So I got to ask you, is the story about you running against horses when you were in high school or growing up or whenever it was, is that actually true?
Yeah, that's actually true. My brother, he was the one that kind of brung it to me. He was the one that, you know, that was doing it at first. He's an animal type guy, so he loves horses, loves, you know, different types of animals. So, you know, for him, you know, doing crazy stuff like that, that's in the norm. And I remember him telling me, he was like, yeah, why don't you just trace horses and use it in, you know, some of your workouts? And I actually did it. And I did it like a couple times, you know, early on, especially in high school, a lot of time before I even went to Alabama. I did it a couple times, and you know, I feel like it was probably one of the most craziest experiences because, you know, they're you know, high power type animals. You know, you get used to seeing that type of speed. Once you see a human being, it's totally different. So, like, that definitely helped me out.
You took a massive step in year two. How does Rashawn Evans take another massive step at linebacker for the Titans in year three?
I would just say continue to do what I've been doing, man. Just making sure that I critique maybe little tedious things to maybe get to that next level. You know, Vrabel always talks about being going from good to great, and you know, those type of things are what basically transitions you over to that. I feel like once I continue to do those things and being able to do everything my coach has asked for me to do, I'll definitely be able to get there.
One of the best to come out of the best conference in America, the SEC, with us this week's Nissan Insider. Rashawn Evans, thanks for the time.
Thank you.